2020 doesn't seem to be easing up when it comes to shock value, as April held its fair share of surprises just like previous months. Here are the trends and stories that were big on social media in the month of April. Babyface and Teddy Riley break Instagram. Fans of R&B from across the globe were given a special treat in April when legendary writers, producers, and artists Babyface and Teddy Riley went head-to-head on Instagram Live on an edition of Versus. The highly anticipated music battle organized by Swizz Beatz and Timbaland actually held twice, the first time on the 18th of April and the rematch on the 20th. The first broadcast was severely affected by technical difficulties because Teddy Riley complicated what was meant to be a simple audio setup with an elaborate production which he tried to pull off in his studio. He had a big screen, a live band, a DJ, a backup dancer, all in his studio, and he complicated the setup, not only affecting the quality of his broadcast, it also led to tons of people making jokes about him and the entire process on social media. It was comedy gold. Even superstars like Toni Braxton got in on the jokes and memes. Anyway, due to technical difficulties, the match was rescheduled to Monday night, and both music legends treated viewers to a medley of their hits. That is, until they broke Instagram and they could no longer connect with each other on Instagram Live. It's reported by Swizz Beatz that over 3 million people tried to tune into the live session, and the singers got cut off because they had surpassed Instagram's capacity. But despite the abrupt end, it was still an awesome, record-breaking night filled with fun memories and great music. Failed attempts to blackmail Toke Makinwa and Tacha. In April, OAP Toke Makinwa and former Big Brother Niger star Tacha revealed that people were trying to blackmail them by releasing lewd pictures of them, pictures that were fake. Toke posted on Instagram saying she received an email from someone saying the images they have of her are yet to be published and they need a response from her, if not, they'll be made public on the internet. Bibi Niger ex-housemate Tacha received a similar email after being notified by members of her team. However, the attached images intended to be used to blackmail both ladies were photoshopped as their heads were put on other people's bodies. Both ladies published the fake pictures and stated clearly that it wasn't them, and they went on to warn the blackmailers to give up with their lame attempts and to stop being unfortunate. Toke went on to say, "I'm not the one. I don't have any money to give you." YouTuber Tayo Aina trends on Twitter. Entrepreneur and YouTuber Tayo Aina trended on Twitter this month after being criticized for sounding too Nigerian and unpolished in his videos. It all began when a video of his titled $2.4 million Lagos apartment review was shared on Twitter by Africa Facts Zone, an account with over 316,000 followers. The clip gradually went viral, and with it began the debate on the logic behind buying such an expensive property in Lagos, and more importantly, how Nigerian some people felt Tayo sounded, and which doesn't, in their minds, align with being a presenter on a media platform. The topic sparked a heated debate on Twitter and touched on a common topic in Nigeria about how it appears some Nigerians either have some kind of inferiority complex or they prefer a foreign-sounding and foreign-looking presenter over our own indigenous-looking and Nigerian-sounding presenters, and even go as far as looking down on them. Scores of Twitter users attacked Tayo, but even more people came to his defense, saying he creates his content by himself and for his own YouTube channel and is under no obligation to try and be anyone other than himself. All the while, Tayo Aina kept on trending and being discovered, and shortly after, his YouTube page, which was on around 92,000 subscribers, raced to the 100,000 subscriber mark within a week. Congratulations on the milestone, Tayo, and keep making dope videos. TikTok experiences incredible growth during lockdown. TikTok, the social video platform, experienced huge growth around the world and in Nigeria in the month of April. We're sure you noticed too. The Chinese video sharing social network had already been very popular among teens around the world, and it had around 800 million users in January. But now, with adults having a lot more time on their hands and with a higher demand for entertainment, TikTok has now neared the 1 billion mark in April. April saw lots of Nigerian celebrities jumping on the incredibly popular app as well. Stars like Don Jazzy, Simi, Chinonso Arubai, Lasisi Elenu, and the Nigerian queen of TikTok so far, Toke Makinwa, all started creating content on the platform and growing their respective audiences. TikTok allows users to post short videos no longer than 60 seconds to showcase bite-sized versions of their talents, which may include dance skills, athletic abilities, or relatable experiences with a humorous twist. The fact that TikTok videos are also used to start viral challenges and are also shared on Instagram has also aided in the platform's incredible growth these past couple of months. The app isn't without controversy though, as America believes that TikTok has privacy issues and that China uses it to spy on foreign nations. Burna Boy criticizes Nigerians. Burna Boy made the news yet again this month, and once again, not for the best reasons. The superstar said in an Instagram video that Nigerians deserve all the things that are happening to them in this country because we have misplaced priorities. Burna was referring to the Accountant General's office, which caught fire in Abuja shortly after relief funds were sent to the country, thereby hinting at foul play and how Nigerians online weren't as enraged about that as they were about Funke Akindele and her husband throwing a birthday party in their home with lots of people in attendance, which violated the social distancing and lockdown orders. He said Nigerians are better off using that same energy to tackle our shady politicians and to demand for better governance rather than calling out hardworking Nigerians like Funke Akindele who are trying their best to make an honest living in a hard country like Nigeria. While many people on social media seemed divided about what Burna Boy said, a majority felt he had a good point, but his choice of words were a bit heavy-handed and unguarded. But hey, I guess that's Oluwa Burna for you. Joe Biden expected to win Democratic ticket after Bernie Sanders drops out. After Bernie Sanders dropped out of the race for the Democratic Party's presidential ticket on April 8th, it made former US Vice President Joe Biden the presumptive nominee for the party. The contest for the Democratic Party's 2020 presidential ticket was keenly fought by other frontline candidates like Michael Bennet, Andrew Yang, Michael Bloomberg, Tulsi Gabbard, and Elizabeth Warren until their respective campaigns like Sanders ran out of steam. Bernie Sanders in the days that followed subsequently endorsed Joe Biden's candidacy and asked all Americans to vote for the former US Vice President in the 2020 American presidential elections in November. On April 14th, former President Barack Obama also endorsed his vice president in a 12-minute video with powerful words and a clear call to action. The Democratic primaries in the US will still continue until early August, but it's expected that Joe Biden's nomination will be announced later that month. He'll be saddled with the task of uniting a very divided Democratic Party, conducting a campaign, and winning an election in a particularly challenging year for the US. Nigerians celebrate Dagrin 10 years after. On April 22nd, Nigerians celebrated the late rapper Oladapo Olaito Olaonupekun, popularly known as Dagrin. 10 years ago, on April 22nd, 2009, the singer passed away in hospital after being involved in a car accident in the early hours of the morning on Agege Motor Road. Dagrin was regarded as a trailblazer and one of the first Nigerian rappers to regularly rap mixing Yoruba, Pidgin and English in his music. He had hits like Pon 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 and Kondo and was on the path to superstardom at the time of his unfortunate demise. He was 25 years old. Fire got Accountant General's office in Abuja. On the 8th, the Capitol unit on the 4th floor of the same building where the Accountant General's office is in Abuja caught fire. Reports say it began when an officer turned on an air conditioner and there was a spark followed by smoke. He turned it off and rushed to get help, but the fire eventually affected a good portion of the 4th and 5th floors. The Minister of State for Budget and National Planning assured the media that a lot of their work has been online and has been backed up, so there is no cause for alarm. However, the fire would be investigated by the relevant authorities. The fire came at a rather suspicious time, however, as Nigeria had only recently received funds from international bodies to tackle the ongoing health issue the nation is facing currently. So many Nigerians wondered if the incident was orchestrated in a bid to cover up certain things. Similar mysterious incidents have been known to happen in the past. The opposition party, the PDP, said that they were shocked that this incident will occur after their increased calls for a forensic audit of the blurry subsidy regime of the current administration, for which sums in the trillions of naira claim to have been spent. President Buhari loses his chief of staff. The chief of staff to the presidency, Abba Kyari, passed on April 17th. He was in his 70s and was the highest profile loss to the virus that's presently assailing much of the world as well as Nigeria. He was reported to have suffered from underlying health issues and he tested positive in late March after visiting Germany. Initially, reports stated that he was getting better with encouraging signs, but subsequently, later in the day on April 17th, presidential spokesman Femi Adesina tweeted that Kyari had passed on. News of the chief of staff's passing wasn't met with the expected level of sympathy from Nigerians, going by their comments on social media. It appeared many on Twitter had one thing or the other to say about the politician and his burial ceremony, which was televised. Those are the trends and stories that were big on social media in April.